you feel, in a sense, all political parties were responsible for pandering to the anti-immigrant sentiment that is prevalent through several parts of Europe right now. Do you fear now that Sebastian Kurz, going forward, will continue along those lines? Are you expecting to see an even further rise in Islamophobia and xenophobia to the point that it will actually change Austria's political policies?
I myself, as an activist for Muslim, for minorities in general, and Muslim, for the Muslim minority here in Austria, which is the biggest religious minority in Austria, we don't have to forget this. I am also concerned about the harsh politics, which was mentioned, towards the Muslim institutions and the laws concerning the headscarves, which exclude Muslim women from the job market, despite good education, but also exclude them from society. And I think not only the far right parties in Austria did this campaigning of Islamophobia and instrumentalized the Muslim community and minority here in Austria, but also, as I mentioned before, all other parties, as left, right, left parties also, and also the Social Democratic Party. And I want to say it again, it's very important for the Muslim minority to have an ally in the parliament, to have a voice against this Islamophobia and to combat this Islamophobic Islamophobia in Austria with the Muslim community.
Okay. I'd like to turn, if we can, to the role that Austria might be playing in the European Union going forward. Christoph, let me